Who or what is keeping us in the dark? Manipulating what we can believe is true. Keeping us from our full potential, our maximum efforts. Topic inspired by Steve Isdall from howtohunt.com and the How to Hunt YouTube channel. With the things I've done in life, where I've worked, where I've traveled, even competing in the drawing. Man, how'd you do that, man? I wish I could do that. Oh man, you must have, you know, you probably were born that way. Here's one thing as a kid. I remember looking at things on TV, looking at drawings of things, particularly of food. And I thought, fuck, what is that? Is that that cranberry sauce that everyone talks about? I wonder what that tastes like. What's that for? What's that silver thing for? Well, that's for the gravy. Wonder how that's made. Apple pie. Wow. Wonder what that tastes like. But I mention those things because what I've accomplished, I've done them while people around me said, oh, that's stupid. Oh, that's a white thing. You can't do that. Or no one in my zip code or where I grew up at does that. Why do I mention that? No, I don't want you to think that I had some positive role models that said, oh, you could do that. You got it, son. You can do it. And I think it's a combination of my culture, my parents, or lack of parents, or my parents' lack of parenting. The victim blaming, small thinking, socialist views from the public schools that I went to. I went to the LAUSD, Los Angeles Unified School District. Kindergarten, elementary school, junior high, and high school. And I can't think, I'm trying to think of all those teachers. See, one, two. One was a substitute teacher who was only teaching because he needed to make some money before he headed off to Harvard Medical School. Dude, brilliant guy, cool guy. And then the woman who gave me my entire art degree and art education, a majority of it, I'll say 98% of it, because the rest I was just taught by looking at other people and just watching them and asking questions. They were not my actual teachers. But I had a teacher who, one art teacher, taught me stippling, which is the black pilot pen, just adding dimension and shading to a subject. I couldn't afford a pilot pen. I didn't have a way to go buy, or didn't even know where to go buy a pilot pen. Especially in the fucking hood. She gave me one. But yeah, man, that was her her idea, her belief. My small lunch I had, she probably could tell that I was a little runt. It's like, oh, you still hungry? I'm like, yeah, have some cookies. And but yeah, my culture, or my raza, my community. That's another thing too. One word that always stands out when I watch the stupid box television. Like today there was, I'm guessing something to do with the Mars cruiser, some robot that's on Mars. And I heard from the news, Despierta America. Yeah, we got 16 Latinos working on it. And I thought, I don't give a fuck what the fuck they are. I don't give a fuck if they're fucking trannies who wear vibrating butt plugs, inject the soy milk into their veins, and worship Satan. And a hardcore recycling tree conservatives, as long as they get the job done, as long as they fucking do things to the best of their abilities. I don't give a fuck. Do you like vanilla ice cream over chocolate ice cream? Yeah, we're guessing when I see these things on TV, I hear our community. I think this is the same community where in high school a friend of mine was gunned down, killed. Same place where some kid, the high school that I went to, in a Latinx neighborhood. Walking by the side of the high school, and I get gunned down on the long sidewalk. That's the community that I'm from. to go to Mexico, where I'm from, where I do business, I make sure that I don't dress like what I have in my pockets or how much I'm buying. Don't look goofy. Stand tall. No, I want the robber to think. Nah, mate, nah, this guy looks like he's gonna be a problem, like he'll resist. He'll fight and probably, I won't be able to take his shit. Yeah, my culture, that's what it taught me. That's what it was like. You'd get murdered going to school, you'd get murdered leaving school. I met there was even a kid that got gunned down. He knew what he was doing. Waiting for the bus. Minutes after high school ended. Shot through the throat. Now he's paralyzed for life. But yeah, I had a school system that taught me how to feel like a victim. I had, I still have that, that news source that says, yeah, the community. Again, I just mentioned what community I lived in, do business in. Went to school in, went to church in. Fuck, no, I don't leave my fucking car down. Remember this one idiot recently tried to make me a victim, rob me or assault me. And he did it in front of a church. And let's just say that he had a bad fucking day. And my mindset was, and this fucker approached me, well, you better kill me. That was my thought. You want my shit? You want to fuck me up? Want me to be your victim? You better be prepared to kill me right now. And me, I thought, no, it's not going to happen. And then, well, with the election of Beijing Biden, when people checking, trying to remember what their official name was, but people that go and verify him, voting, people that go verify votes, were told to stay 6 feet apart, 10 feet apart, to stand behind the closed doors and closed blinds. And people who thought that they were videoing fake ballots being sent to various states. giving us our dear leader, Beijing Biden. And I know someone was saying, well, you know, the court just said that Biden won the election fair and square. Remember, this is the same government that said Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. Same same government that said, built Tower 7 on 9/11. Died from entirely collapsed based off of the Twin Towers attack. And same government that the day before 9/11 said, we're missing $1 trillion. We'll just make a note on that and get back to you on that investigation. Same government that lied about that evil bitch Hillary Clinton. When Americans were getting murdered, slaughtered in Benghazi, the US Embassy. But yeah, Beijing buying one fair and square. And the cocksucker Kamala Harris, yeah. Everybody loved her. Yeah, for me, the so-called family tradition, neighborhood culture, public school system, the media. Can't leave out those celebrities. Celebrities that want to do publicity stunts so that they can remain relevant. The celebrities that have bodyguards that live in the neighborhoods that you don't live in. You're just a hater, man. It's because you're not famous. Throughout all of that, I don't know, something within me just said, question that. And eventually I learned the term trust but verify. You know, 'cause I didn't trust the motherfucker in church, in school. And I just went off my instinct. And I think with all these video games, which I've enjoyed playing, with all this goals of being a famous TikToker, which I wouldn't mind being, but to be something that doesn't maximize people's potential or your own potential. Check out this one YouTuber I like. I need to figure out if it's called like Mpoko na Mi Pueblo or. But it's a food channel of a woman that just cooks from her. Humble, very humble kitchen in Mexico. And I'll even go deep into the deeper end. The one with Tata. You know, oh, that wasn't a UFO that you saw. Crazy. Ghost. The unexplained. You know, things that many people throughout various parts of the world say exist. But I think it's various people that are put in Hollywood news media, especially the news media, and political power. People who are eventually corrupted to own private businesses. It keeps us weak, keep us divided, keep us fighting each other. And to me, again, fuck your skin color, fuck your flag, fuck wherever your mom or dad is from. I don't give a shit. Let your reputation speak for itself. Just get it fucking done. That's all I give a fuck about. Get it fucking done. Get the fuck out my way. And remember, there are no easy days, simply days where potential was not fulfilled.